Hi, I'm Elin from exocad. Today we are proud to present the highlights of exoplan 3.1 Rijeka. I'm excited to show you the great new features and improvements which have been implemented thanks to you, our users, your wishes and valuable feedback. And of course, also thanks to our great developer team. In this version, we have five new key features and six key software improvements. So let's dive in and explore the new things exoplan Rijeka has to offer.
Let's start in the exoplan DB. One of our new key features in exoplan 3.1 Rijeka is that it's now possible to plan for upper and lower jaw at the same time. For this video, I have loaded our demo case, patient Rosa, which is a case where the patient is edentulous in the upper jaw and has some residual dentition in the lower jaw. I have an optical scan of the lower jaw, and as you can see, we now have a 3D preview of the optical scan data available directly in the DB. I also have the patient DICOM and the DICOM of the prosthesis for the upper jaw. When we look in the action menu, we find a new button called Rapid Pre-Planning. This is another new key feature in exoplan 3.1 Rijeka. Let's take a look at that first. The goal of the rapid pre-planning mode is to analyze the CBCT data of the patient and, if possible, do an initial positioning of implants. It can be used as a tool when communicating with the patient to show what a future treatment could look like. I start by loading the DICOM data of the patient. In this version, we have added an incognito mode. When the incognito mode is on, the patient name is not visible. The feature can be activated in the settings menu. Since I have defined implant sites in both upper and lower jaw for this case, the software wants to know which jaw I want to work on. As I mentioned in the beginning, it is now possible to work on both jaws at the same time, and I will select that option. This is the default view arrangement for the rapid pre-planning mode. In the axial view, the panoramic curve is automatically detected at start. As always, I can also define it manually if I want. The automatic curve detection can be activated again in the axial view menu. I used intersection markers to orient through the data and find the area of interest. In this version, it is possible to define the depth of the panoramic view with these control points. The panoramic view shows the area between the yellow lines. You can see how it changes when I reduce or enlarge the distance between the yellow lines. Another improvement in this version is the possibility to save your own preferred view arrangements as default for any workflow step. Simply open the implant control, select which views you want and in which arrangement you want them. Then click the Save button. The next time you open the step, it will open with your preferred view arrangement. You can save different arrangements for each workflow step. To delete your saved view arrangements, click the brush button. When using exoplan in the rapid pre-planning mode, you can open the implant positioning step with this button without the need to go through all other steps necessary for a complete planning. As you can see, we have made several improvements to the implant positioning step. For now, I will just select one implant and place it roughly. I do not need to place all implants and can simply close the implant positioning step when I have done the positioning I want. When I click the right mouse button, the context menu shows some additional steps that are available when working in the rapid pre-planning mode. When you are finished in the rapid pre-planning mode, you can start the wizard and select your next step. If you select to save a scene, you can open the scene in the normal planning mode to finish the implant planning whenever you want. In this video, I will continue to finalize the planning directly. When you select this option, the wizard opens in the next workflow step needed to finish the implant plan. Since I'm working with both upper and lower jaw, I will define which alignment workflow to use for each jaw before I continue. Aligning the CT data is necessary if you later want to design a surgical guide. If you do not want a surgical guide for the current case, you can skip the alignment and continue the implant planning without aligning the CT data. Since I want to create surgical guides for this case, I select the alignment workflow I want to use. For the lower jaw, I have an intraoral optical scan and I therefore select the CT to mesh alignment for the lower jaw. For the upper jaw, I select the CT to CT alignment since I have a CBCT scan of the upper jaw prosthesis. First, I perform the CT to mesh alignment for the lower jaw. In this version, you can place the points first in one view and then the other if you prefer. I start the best fit alignment by clicking Next, and after checking the alignment, I continue by confirming the alignment as acceptable. Next step is to align the upper jaw, and since I selected CT to CT alignment for the upper jaw, it is time to load the DICOM of the prosthesis for the upper jaw. I'm selecting a threshold for the prosthesis visualization that represents what the prosthesis looks like in reality, since I want to use the generated mesh of the prosthesis later for my guide design. We have revised the look of the mesh editing to make it easier to switch between freeforming and cropping. We have also made mesh editing available as a step of its own, called 3D Surface Editor, which is available in expert mode whenever you need it. When I continue with Next, the automatic alignment over the radio POC markers in the two DICOM datasets is performed. The alignment looks perfect and I can continue with acceptable alignment. Next step is the Define Mandibular Canal step. Two new buttons, Move Anterior and Move Posterior, have been added to make it easier to move through the slices of the CBCT data with a curve cut view. Use the slider to set the incremental distance for these buttons. Also new in this step is that you can skip the marking completely if you want. Just click Next and select to continue without marking the canal. A note will be added to the report with information that the step was skipped. Let's continue to the next step, which is the sinus segmentation step. I place the seed point, check the threshold and adjust it. Then I start the segmentation and create the collision object. As you can see, when I created a mesh object for this sinus, I got a collision with the implant I already placed in the rapid pre-planning mode. In Exoplan 3.1 Rijeka, you can continue even if you have a collision with the sinus object. It will be mentioned in the report, but maybe you also want to add a screenshot of the area to the report. That you can now do easily with the new screenshot and image management tool. Use the screenshot button for the view you want to capture. The image is added to the screenshot and image management tool, which can be opened from the tool menu. All open views also have a corresponding button within the management tool, which generates a screenshot of that view. You can also select the screenshot region manually. You can use the edit function to further highlight areas of interest. If you want the screenshots included in the reports, just check the corresponding checkbox. Maybe you have an image saved somewhere else that you want to include in the report. No problem, just upload it using the corresponding button and check the box to add it to the report. In the next steps, I'll add the model teeth. Of course, I can skip the model teeth if I'd like. In the correct tooth placement step, we have a new tab, Advanced, with some improved options to modify the tooth models. Now we have arrived at the implant positioning step. One of our new key features in Rijeka 3.1 is that it's now possible to place both implants, prosthetic parts, sleeves and anchor pins within the same step. It doesn't matter if you select your implant, surgical component or prosthetic component first. When you have made your first selection and switch to another component type, the selection dialog will show you only compatible options from your installed libraries. As you can see, the implant I placed during the rapid pre-planning is in the scene, and when I want to select my surgical component, sleeve and kit, only the options that are compatible to my implant are visible in the selection dialog. I can filter for different library types. For instance, here I can select to only show me sleeve libraries or only kit libraries. I can of course filter for my favorites. I will place the fully guided Exodemo sleeve and the Exodemo abutment. In this version, you can change the implant diameter easily by moving this arrow. Let's move on to implant site 1-2. The software automatically selected the same implant for this position as the one I initially placed for implant site 1-5. If I clear that selection now after selecting all components for implant site 1-5 and again click on implant site 1-2, the same components, implants, sleeve and prosthetic part selected for implant site 1-5 are automatically selected for 1-2. I will clear the selection for 1-2 again to show you what the selection dialog looks like when nothing has been pre-selected. When I am in the implant selection dialog, I can filter to only show me guided implants. If I also activate the favorite filter, I see only guided implants that I also marked as favorites. The 8mm long Exodemo implant is grayed out since I have filtered for guided implants. I select implant, sleeve and prosthetic part and place it in the scene. To place an anchor pin, click the anchor pin button for the jaw you want to place the anchor pin in. The selection dialog opens and you can select which one you want. The anchor pin selection does not depend on which implant you might have placed already. You can choose from all your installed anchor pin libraries. On the right side, we have filter buttons to filter the list. Select to show only upper jaw, or lower jaw, or both. Select to show only implant, anchor pins, or both. We have added the Add Remove Implant button to the upper left side. You can alter your implant setup here. Let's remove some of the implant sites for now to make the planning faster. Another improvement in this version is that we have included the library manager. If you are missing a library, you can now easily download the one you need directly within the software, and the library manager will install it for you. You must reboot to access the newly installed library. Let's have a look under the implant control again. We have added two new 2D views. One user-defined 2D view, which you can place wherever you want, and a second implant cross view to complement the first implant cross view. We also made the 3D view optional for those of you who prefer to only work with the 2D views opened. As mentioned earlier in this video, you can now save your preferred view arrangement for each step. In the implant positioning step, you can actually save two view arrangements, one for before the implant is placed, and one for when you adjust the placement. Let's place the implants for the lower jaw as well and continue. In Exoplan 3.1 Rijeka, you can continue even if you have a collision with the sinus object. Before I start to generate the result files, I get a chance to check that the screenshots I marked to add in the reports are still up to date. Since I changed the position of the implant after these screenshots were made, I will remove them from the report, will make a note, and add a new screenshot of the current situation. Now it is time to approve the planning and generate the implant planning result files. When we look at the implant planning report, we can see some enhancements to the layout, and at the end we have the screenshots that were selected for the implant planning report. The first step of the surgical guide design in Exoplan 3.1 Rijeka is new and offers the possibility to load any scan you want to use for your guide design. You can align the scan to the current scene objects with the alignment tool, known from Dental CAD. I switch to tab manually to rotate and move the loaded scan to a position that makes it possible for me to see both the loaded scan and the object I want to align my scan to. Press Ctrl and drag the mouse to rotate the loaded scan. Press the left mouse button and drag the mouse to move the loaded scan. When I have the scan in the position I want, I switch to tab automatically. I place a few alignment points and start the alignment. I open the secondary views to check the alignment and perform the best fit alignment. If the scan you load is a prosthesis, make sure to check the corresponding box to get the correct design workflow. I will use the original scans for this design, so I will delete the object I just loaded. The next step is define gingiva contact surface for upper jaw. Here I can start by using the mesh editing to clean up the generated prosthesis mesh a bit, since I will use this for my guide design. Of course, the mesh editing has the revised look also in this step to simplify the use of freeforming and cropping. As I said, I will use the shape of the prosthesis for the design of the guide for the upper jaw. In this next step, design sleeve mounts, there is nothing new. I use the tabs to change the anchor pin mounts and apply printer presets. Time to design the guide bottom for the lower jaw guide. And now the top part for the lower jaw guide. In the attachment step, we have added toggle buttons for upper and lower jaw. I'm going to place a few attachments and then continue to the merge step. When the merge has finished, I can do some freeforming of the merged surgical guides if I'd like. For the edentulous upper jaw, I will select to create a fixation guide. Here, I can place attachments to the fixation guide and then continue to merge this guide as well. Freeform the fixation guide if you'd like. Before I start to generate the result files, I get a chance to check that the screenshots I marked to add to the surgical report are still up to date. Now we can take a look at the surgical guide report. New is that we now display the full drill sequence. This feature is available for those implants and surgical kits for which the manufacturer has chosen to integrate the full drill sequence in our software. In the full drill sequence protocol, each step during the surgery is listed if you have chosen a fully guided system for which the full drill sequence has been implemented. At the end of the report, we can see the screenshots I selected to include in the surgical report. Now, the implant planning and surgical guide design are finished.
I hope you enjoyed this video and that you are excited to try out the new Exoplan 3.1 Rijeka. Thank you for watching.